So we've covered a few basics here about things in Photoshop, you know, selection tools, the move tool, cloning, so on and so forth. Now, before we go too far into anything, we want to make sure we're saving it. It wouldn't be the first time over the course of a semester that a student has lost everything because they didn't save. So, boy, it's a good habit to just maintain always. I know when I'm in my hyper-paranoid states, I save almost after every maneuver. It's just Command-S. Pretty much will do it. But for the sake of demonstration, we always want to go to File and Save. Well, actually, it's now Save As, because when it's already saved, the actual save word will be grayed out. So Save As. Now, underneath Save As, that makes a new copy while maintaining the original. We have our top dialog to Save As. We can give it a new copy, or a new name, if you want. We want to make sure we save it in the correct place. Now, I think I will save this on my desktop for now. I'll call this Suncups Copy 2. Now, this is all, we tend to click through these rather quickly, and I encourage you to stop, take a breath for a minute, because down here at the bottom is where we have the format. And the format is pretty important. Depending on the project you're working on, you might want to save it as a JPEG, or I prefer to save everything as a Photoshop file, which gives us the extension up here of .psd for Photoshop document. PSDs save all of the data. It's not a compressed saving format the way, say, a JPEG is. Now, I've got a whole lecture where I stand in front of the class, flap my hands, describing how JPEG compression works. And essentially, what JPEG does is it saves a portion of each tone. For example, it'll say, hey, there's a lot of blue here, there's a lot of white here, there's a lot of dark here. I'm going to save 10% of this and discard the rest. Then when I reopen the file, I will multiply that blue content. So it's an imperfect, uses an algorithm to replicate it, duplicate it, and rebuild the picture. And it's not good for long-term storage. It's good for temporary. In fact, if you look at this picture, if you look at this picture, we've got, see right on that ridge line there, how it's not real clean, there's kind of like a band of light blue. That's an artifact of too much JPEG compression. Because so many this picture's been open and closed so many times that parts of it just deteriorate and the computer just can't open it cleanly anymore. So you want to avoid that. You got to do it a lot. I mean, your picture is not going to evaporate in a year. But good practice, good habits mean that you really should save it as a PSD. And then, well, what I do is that I save everything as a PSD first, and then I do a save as a JPEG for what I'm going to deliver to somebody or send, say, an email or something. Now, when you select JPEG, you hit save, then you get this little dialog for JPEG options. You have an image quality thing here. Now, you can move the image quality slider to maximum or to minimum. Now, I used that example of saving a portion of the blues in the skies. That's really what this control does. Under maximum, you're saying, I'm going to save a large percentage of the blue. Under minimum, you're going to save a small percentage. In fact, when I have this down here, you can see the artifacts, how the blue pixels are blocking up. That's meaning that it's going to discard a lot of the information, and it's going to hurt the overall image quality. So JPEGs are good for short-term saving copies of things, but not good for long-term. You'll also get a little number here in the bottom right or middle right of how large the file will be or how much the digital file will weigh, which is handy to know sometimes. Anyway, I'll click OK there, and it's showing up on my desktop on another screen. Also, when you do Save As, there are other formats, which I know are covered in another lecture in the course. We have JPEG, there's Photoshop, there's CompuServe, GIF. Now, GIF maintains some transparency, as does PNG. So these are other formats that we'll cover, I believe, under Illustrator more than Photoshop. But we also have Photoshop PDF, which we tend to use a lot for delivery of documents and at the end of the semester when we're doing your final project of a portfolio, this format might come in handy quite a bit. So know these formats are all here. They're in the pull-down menu under Format. But the big deal here with saving is that make sure you save a copy and make sure you keep track of where you save it because you don't want to spend time searching. Okay, enough for now. Enjoy. We have a lab assignment next. And so click on the Jason Kendall picture and we'll do a quick tutorial on what to do there. And then you're on your own.